Welcome to our cPanel tutorial. Today, we're going to show you how to manage your domains using the cPanel Domains interface. Before we get into the specifics of managing domains in cPanel, it's important to understand what a domain is and why it matters. So, what exactly is a domain? A domain is essentially the user-friendly address of your website on the internet, just as Minute Maid Park is the user-friendly name for 501 Crawford Street. The main purpose of a domain is to provide a memorable and easy-to-type address for websites, making it simpler for users to find and access them. Without domains, we'd have to use numerical IP addresses, like 192.168.1.1, which are much harder to remember. No two websites can have the same domain name. This uniqueness ensures that when users enter a domain into their browser, they are directed to the correct website. Domains can also have subdomains, which are extensions of the main domain. For example, blog.cpanel.net is a subdomain of cpanel.net. Subdomains are often used to organize different sections of a website. As your online presence expands, you might need to add more domains, create subdomains for different sections of your site, or set up a domain alias. The domains interface in cPanel provides a centralized location for managing all these aspects of your domains to meet your needs efficiently. You can handle everything from adding new domains to configuring DNS settings. Let's get started. First, log in to your cPanel account. Once you're in, scroll down to the domains section and click on the domains icon. You will see a list of domains on your cPanel account. Let's create a new domain now. To add a new domain, click Create a New Domain. In the interface that appears, enter the new domain name you want to add. Then, you will need to choose whether you want to share the domain's document root with another domain or create a new one. But what is the domain's document root? The document root is like a filing cabinet for your website. All the public files for your website, like the homepage, images, and styles, are stored there. For most users, you'll want to create a new document root. Once you've completed the form, click Submit. Your new domain will be added to your cPanel account. Now let's do something a little more complex. We're going to create a subdomain for the domain example.com. To do this, click Create a New Domain, like we did before. In the Domains text box, enter a new name followed by a period and then the website's domain. For example, let's say you want to create a blog for your website. Enter blog.example.com to create a subdomain of example.com. After you've entered the subdomain, click Submit and create another. You'll see a success notification. Now, let's create a shop for our website. Click Submit. In the Domains list table, you'll see the new subdomains we created. Click the home icon or the file path to navigate to the File Manager interface for that domain. You can use the File Manager interface to manage and edit your files. We cover our File Manager interface in another video. I will add a link to the tutorial and documentation below. If the listed subdomain redirects to a different domain, the destination will appear here. To manage redirects, go to the Redirects interface. I'll put a link to our redirects documentation in the description below. You can also click a domain to visit the public-facing website. Let's go back to the list domains view. You can use the Force HTTPS redirect toggle to automatically redirect a domain's visitors from the insecure version of the website to the secure version. You'll probably want to set up a new email address for your domain to communicate with website users. We can create one by clicking on Create Email. This will redirect you to the email accounts interface. I'll drop a link to our email accounts documentation in the description below. Let's click the Manage button. Here you can manage the domain's document root directory, remove the domain, or perform other actions. For example, our shop isn't profitable, so let's remove it. Click Remove Domain. You will be asked to confirm that you want to remove this domain. Click Yes, remove this domain to remove it. You will receive a success message. For more information about cPanel, your hosting platform of choice, visit our website at cPanel.net or follow us on social media at cPanel. Thank you so much for watching and have a great day.